Now let's do one last case. Let's suppose that we have a load that's complex. Let's use our favorite old load here, 100 plus J100 ohms on a 50 ohm transmission line. So I get 2 plus J2. That spot right there. There's my load. And let's say that I want to match that to a transmission line with a characteristic impedance of Z0. Another way I can do that is to use a quarter wave transformer and just put a characteristic impedance transmission line which has a characteristic impedance ZQ. It's going to be lambda by 4 long. ZQ is going to be the square root of Z0, which is what I want, and ZA, which is right here, as long as ZA is strictly real. That's what we've done before. So here's my load, and it's not strictly real at the moment. It has this imaginary component. In order to make it strictly real, I want to get to this axis, any place on this axis where the imaginary part is zero. So I'm going to move towards the generator, that's this distance right here, until I get on the real axis. So here we go, measure my distance, use my piece of paper, put it right there. Here is ZA, and ZA is strictly real. What is ZA? ZA, read your real part right there, is 4, and then I need to remember to denormalize it by multiplying by Z0. So that is about 200 ohms. That's what we plug in right here. 50 ohms is what we plug in for Z0. This tells us the characteristic impedance of our quarter wave transformer. So the only difference between matching a real load with a quarter wave transformer and matching a complex load with a quarter wave transformer is that you move a distance d between your load and the quarter wave transformer in order to get ZL to be strictly real.